Hello, I'm Anthony Vaughn with Texas Instruments' high-speed amplifier marketing team. Today I will demonstrate the key features of TI's THS4552 RTW Evaluation Module, or EVM. The THS4552 is a dual-channel, low-noise, rail-to-rail output, fully differential high-speed amplifier that's ideal for use in differential active filter designs and for driving the input of high-resolution delta-sigma and SAR analog-to-digital converters. The amplifier features an extremely low 3.3 nanovolt per root hertz input voltage noise, along with 150 megahertz bandwidth at unity gain. More information about the THS4552 can be found at the link shown at the bottom of the screen. The THS4552 evaluation module is designed to quickly and easily demonstrate the functionality and versatility of the amplifier. It comes ready to connect to power, two differential signal sources, and test instruments through the use of onboard connectors. The EVM consists of a single small circuit board shown here. The top side of the board features four input signal SMA connectors, the THS4552 amplifier, a differential to single-ended transformer or balance circuit, and two output signal SMA connectors. The bottom side of the board features four black ground connectors or test points, a red connector for the VS positive amplifier supply, a yellow connector for the VS negative amplifier supply, two red connectors for the VOCM amplifier common mode voltage inputs, and two power down control jumpers. When the power down jumper is in place, the amplifier is configured to be in power down mode. When the jumper is removed, the amplifier is in the normal operating mode. To get started using the board, ensure that the power down jumpers for both amplifier channels are removed. The board may be configured for either split supply operation or for single supply operation. For split supply operation, connect the positive supply voltage to the red VS plus connector. Then connect the negative supply voltage to the yellow VS minus connector and the ground reference to one of the black ground connectors. For single supply operation, the VS minus connector and the ground connector should be connected to ground. The output common mode voltage will default to mid-supply if the red VOCM connector is left floating. Regardless of the configuration, the inputs and outputs must be biased per the THS4552 datasheet specifications for proper operation. Once the supply connections have been made, input signals may be connected to the board. By default, the amplifier on the board is configured for a gain of 1. Differential input signals can be applied to the N+ and N- SMA connectors for either or both of the amplifier channels like this. For best results, the signal should be routed to the EVM with cables that have a 50 ohm impedance. The EVM comes configured to have a single-ended output with 50 ohm termination for both channels. This output is available on the OUT1 plus and OUT2 plus SMA connectors on the board. SMA cables can be connected to these terminals to route the signal to test equipment or to another circuit board. The output interface shows a 1 kilo ohm differential load at the device output pins and converts through the balun to a single-ended 50 ohm source with about negative 30 dB insertion loss. The EVM board supports several other input and output configurations with a few minor circuit board modifications. For more details about the different configurations available, take a look at the full EVM user's guide that can be downloaded from the link shown below. The user guide also contains complete board schematics and a parts list. You can also get additional information about the THS4552 EVM and order a development kit from this webpage. To see TI's entire portfolio of fully differential amplifiers, check out ti.com/FDA. I hope that you have found this overview useful. Thank you for watching.